I'm the Beer Babe of beerbabe.blogspot.com. We're at the Coat of Arms, and I'm here for the beer.
I'm Amy at Here for the Beer. Today we're at the Coat of Arms interviewing the beer babe, Carla. Nice to meet you, Carla.
Nice
Thank
to meet you.
Thank you so much for coming out today and chatting with us.
Thanks for your invitation.
The Beer Babe actually is a website, so Carla, can you tell us what that is?
The website address itself is beer-babe.blogspot.com. I've been writing it for about a year, and it's basically my reviews.
Yep. Carla reviews beers, I'm guessing, about three times a week because we're seeing a
twice a week, yep.
Okay, we're seeing a lot of reviews coming out of your site.
Yep.
Tell us, what was the premise? What inspired you to start writing this blog spot?
About 2 years ago, I lived in a house with five other people. And we lived down the corner from an awesome place to buy beer that had six packs of things I had never heard of. So we used to bring them home, split them among the roommates, and talk about them and decide whether or not we liked the beer. And after doing this for a year, we had about 150 bottles of things that we had tried throughout the whole year and realized that none of us remembered anything about any of the beers that we had tried. So I decided to scratch that and kind of start all over, and actually I started the site for myself just to write down what I had thought about certain beers and try to describe them for other people, just as an aid to my own memory. And it grew to be something that a lot of people found fascinating just because it was beer they had never tried and they could get a sense of what it was like and maybe would venture to try it after reading some of my reviews. So it's grown since then. In the past year I started doing it two times a week just because I have that much beer to review. And it's been a neat thing for me to be both wrestle with how to describe beer and both just to be able to recommend beer to people that have never tried it or really just want to venture into craft beer.
Well, I've noted as a woman beer drinker that there are few women at a lot of the events that I'm attending. What's your take on bringing women into the beer world?
I think the major thing that's stopping a lot of women from drinking beer has to be just the fact that they have a preconceived notion of what beer either tastes like, or the fact that dark beer is, has more calories or is more unhealthy for them, or just that beer is something manly and that they don't really have an in into that kind of world. But the truth is that there are so many different styles of beer, from light to dark, from weird to normal, from ales to lagers, that I really think that there's a beer out there that if you could find, your tastes, you could wrap your head around it. And I think that as our tastes become more sophisticated, just as women, we know what we like, we know what we don't like. But the more we become exposed to craft beer, I think there's going to be more women in the beer market.
Excellent. So if you had a woman sitting next to you that never tried a beer, what direction would you point her? Would you take her sweet lambics or would you take her dark stouts? Where would you start?
I usually start people with wheat beers or Hefeweizens. Hefeweizen being the unfiltered kind of weedy, because it has a different taste than that typical beer that everybody knows from college, that kind of watered down, pilsner-ish, light, thin beer. But it has a taste all its own. It's kind of sweet, it has a little bit of citrus in it, sometimes they serve it with an orange depending on, which bar you're in. And it has this taste that makes people recognize, especially women, that there's more taste to beer than just that thing that they consider beer. And it's a good entry-level beer because it's a wheat style, you can move from to Belgians from that, or if they're more into the, kind of malty character of things, you can move on to porters. I've had good luck showing people porters because they don't taste anything like any of the beers that they've ever had.
We love your website. We think it's a great introduction to beer. It helps to put beer into simple language for people, and we just find that that's just totally awesome.
Thanks.
So what do you have going on for 2009? Is there something new for the Beer Babe?
Well, I actually, a lot of the beer sites that I read put together like a top 10 of 2008 list at the end of the year and really had their kind of year in review. And I decided to flip that on its head, and I actually set up a poll on my website and I said, what would you really like to see from the Beer Babe next year? If you had your choice. And I put up things like try more international beer, go to more brew pubs, things that I had been thinking about anyway. And one of the things that I put on there was to try homebrewing. And almost 60% of the people who responded said, oh, you have to try homebrew and you have to tell us all about it, because a lot of my readers are women and they've never tried making their own beer, and neither have I. So it's kind of on the top of my list, is to actually make a batch of my own beer, at least one, and continue from there kind of playing around the things. I've already bought a huge stockpot you know, and I've been kind of gathering ingredients and checking out homebrew stores near me. So it's an adventure, and I'm calling it my homebrewing adventure. So I've been writing little posts just on, oh, I bought this cool pot the other day, and I don't know if I'm going to use malt extract or not, and all these wonderful people have been giving me feedback. So I'm quite excited to kind of go in that direction, but I don't think I'm going to stop doing the reviews for that. It's just going to be an addition to what I've already got planned.
Thank you so much for chatting with us today, Carla. We really enjoy your site. We're looking forward to seeing your new brewing adventures.
Thanks.
And for everyone else out there, thank you so much for tuning in. We're here for the beer.